Hi, Peter from CALLOUTS here. Today I'm happy to present our latest and greatest new Camtasia template collection, Masks. The collection includes more than 40 different mask templates, and I will try to show you a little bit about them in this video and how you can use masks and a little bit of tricks that you can do when using masks in Camtasia. So I hope you'll enjoy it. If you have any questions or any comments, please don't hesitate to put a little comment below the video on YouTube. Okay, so let's check out the templates. The templates are, as usual, very easy to use. They install here in the library that of your choosing. And once installed, you will find a folder called 85 Masks Artist Useful. It has five different folders with masks. We have Artistic Grunge Horizontal, Square, Gradients, Vignettes, and Windows. And a little help file here as well. All of them are already prepared with properties, so you can drop them on top of a layer you want to mask out. Once it's on top, the masked area will show the underlying layer. First out, we have two artistic grunge folders here, and they are there are different masks in them, but they all have the same style. So in the horizontal one, you have full HD 1920x1080 masks. And in the square one, they are 1080x1080 pixels to make square videos. Okay, so let's take a look at how one uses this. Okay, so let's take a look here. Here we have the horizontal grunge masks, and I'm picking number 7 here and dragging it down to the timeline. So this is what it looks like, and the masking effect, the matte effect, has already been applied to this layer, so you can just drop it down and use it directly. And normally the black part would hide the underlying layer, but because I'm using the inverted version now, the black will actually show the underlying layer and the white will show two layers under. So I have here two layers. I have a coffee layer and a graphic, actually, a gradient. You can see this is a video and this is an image. Here, nothing happens. So when I place the layer under, the black part now with the inverted version is showing the underlying layer and the white is showing through the next layer or track below that. So that's how easy it is to use the grunge ones. And I can show you quickly how they look here a little bit. So, very nice. I hope you'll agree. If you wanted to reverse the effect and actually show the coffee in the surrounding area and the underlying track in the center, you would just need to choose luminosity instead of the inverted one, and it will have the opposite effect. So next up we have the gradients section, and in this folder you have 7 different gradients. You have a 45 degree from the upper corner down. You have a horizontal version, a one with a radial black in the center, white in the center, and a reflective one, and a reflective white, and a simple vertical one. Now, I haven't included gradients horizontal from the other direction, the vertical from the other direction. If you want to do it the other way around, you just have to turn them around. So you could turn it around either by just dragging it around like that, and you will have a reversed mask there, or you could just enter the rotation 180 degrees and you will have the reversed mask there. So let's control Z that to go back. Now, why is this interesting? With the these gradient masks, you can actually mix layers. An easier way of blending layers together, I could say. So let me drop in a couple of things here. Let's do a curl bar here. And now you see this one is already applied. So in this case, it is the luminosity. So black will conceal. You mask out with a black part and you reveal with a white part. So I reveal the video under with the white part while the black shows another layer. So this layer is affected by the mask. So I turn that on again. Now the project setting is set to white. If I would change the project setting to black, then this part should turn black. Like that. Okay. But what we want to do now is we want to mix coffee with exercise here a little bit. So I drag this down and you can see the two videos blend together. Let me play a little bit for you here. So now, if you want to edit how much or where the blending takes place a little bit, one way would be to change the opacity of the blending layer. That means that this one would be less seen. So if I pull down the opacity, more and more coffee is seen through and less of the exercising girl here. So that's one way of doing it, but since opacity stops at 100%, we can't put more than 100% opacity. A better and easier way to do this is actually to change the scale of the gradient. So I will back out a little bit here to for you to see it, and then I scale it up. And now we have black in this area. If I move it more, we're going to see more of the coffee. And if I move it more in this direction, we're going to see more of the exercise. So that's one way, an easier way to work with the level of gradients. So that's one way of blending together using this. And it works, of course, the same with the 45 degree and the radial ones. We can take a look. We will take the white one because the center will be shown through. You see it's very weak here. The center of the layer below, because it's white, is shown through. And it's again 100% there. So again, I will scale it up to get more of an effect. And then move it so we see more of that part. So a very easy and effective way of blending videos together, as you can see. Okay, let's jump to the next section, vignettes. Here we have six different vignettes. Five of them, I would say, is simple basic vignettes. These are actually not using the mask, but are just transparent layers. So you don't need to change any settings. So if I, you see what happens in the video, and if I hide the vignette like that, that's the difference. That's the round one. We have a round strong one, a super strong one, round weak, and a square one. The square one is a little bit like a TV with soft edges. So what I wanted to show you especially was the focus point. And we will hide the layer underneath. Now, this one is a masked one. And the advantage of that is you can't have anything under because it's going to show the layer underneath. But you have total flexibility here with it. So you can make it as small or as big as you want. So you want to just show a piece of the video like that. You can animate it, of course. You can actually change size if you want to drag it. If you drag it, and it will just completely change size. But if you hold down shift, you can also change it. So I will hold down shift. You can change the width and height of it. So that's the focus point vignette. That's the vignettes. And finally, we have the Windows version. And here we have 8 windows. These are also PNGs, not actual masks. So you won't be affected by what is underneath the layer you want to work with. So we have one big window. You can't see them really there. You gotta drag them down. As you see, it's similar to the one we showed before with the soft edges. This is a hard-edged one. You have a two-window version where you can show two different videos. You have a three different version. You have two wide windows. You have three windows to the side. And you have many windows. And you have especially what you could use, for example, for when you're doing a video with a talking head. You can have the video playing here. And you can place yourself in that little square. Or if you have an interview situation, for example, you can use this one where you have the video showcasing there and the two in the interview and interviewer there. So let's show an example with three different videos, for example, here. So what I will do now is to place the videos. We will keep this curl bar in the middle, and I have it marked. I will hold down Alt, and the frame is blue. This means that I can crop it very easily and quickly. So I will hold it down. I will then drag the edges of it so it only covers that window. Now I can, because it's a file, not a mask, I can have multiple layers and show through here, which was the idea of this thing. Let's see if I have any videos I can put in, the coffee we can put in. And I do the same thing here. I hold down the Alt when the coffee layer is chosen and I drag it to the left. And there I have the coffee layer there. Let's drag this out a little bit and remove that. And let's pick a third one here for the third window. And we're gonna move this one over. I could either use, have it highlighted and use the cursor keys. Could be a little slow, or I can just hide the layer on top so I can drag it. I want to have it placed somewhat there. Let's see, something like that. And now I will mask it out. I only need to mask this out from the left-hand side, really. So there. Now we have our three videos. And let's play it and see how that looks. So, there you go. That is a lot of masks. And I think, I mean, if you take a look at this and start using them, you will find incredibly useful scenarios for these. And I hope that you really will enjoy them and that will be a great addition to your Camtasia arsenal. Thank you so much for watching. And if you're not a member of Callouts yet, I really suggest that you take a look, because I think that you will really like what you find there. We have more than 1,000 Camtasia templates up right now, and more coming every month. If you have any questions about this video or our assets, you can comment below in the YouTube video comment area. And hope to see you very soon. Okay, thank you so much for watching. Bye.